the best-kept success secret. It's time you understand that the absolute easiest and most profitable way to get things done in business is to get help. It's all about the contacts you make. Trying to make it alone and fighting against the odds is what you've been taught, but it's wrong. You need help. How often do you take the time to build relationships online? The answer to that question will determine how far you get. I constantly search out new friends and business associates because I know that there will come a time when I will need or want their help and vice versa. When you actively seek out relationships with others in your market, you automatically open yourself up to opportunities that the average business person would easily miss because they're out of the loop. Examples. There are a lot of products I didn't have to buy because their creators who happen to be friends of mine gave me access so that I could help them with any design and marketing strategy questions they had. I have over 15 gigs worth of various digital products I got free. This also puts me in a position to work with these same marketers on future projects, which is always a good position to be in. Joint ventures are extremely easy to get going because I can always contact the people I've worked with in the past to do more deals. Having to constantly search out new people to work with costs you time that you could have been using to make money. Setting up joint ventures is just a simple matter of sending out a few emails to people who are already used to hearing from me. There are many services that others routinely pay for that I get for free or at a deeply discounted price because of the contacts I've established over the years. That's why they'll sometimes perform services for me without the need for money exchanging hands. They know that when my area of expertise is needed, I'll gladly help. The right relationships mean more money. Having contacts just for the sake of having them is worthless. You need to make the right contacts. You need to build relationships with people who can help you get to where you want to be. But, in order to do that, you must have something valuable to offer in return. There's only so much a friend will help you do. You will need to offer a valuable service in return for the one you want from your contact. That's just the way it works. If you don't have the money to get things done, then you need to get creative. You don't have to do everything yourself. Search for people who know how to do what you want done and strike up a conversation with them. There are actually people out there who love to create products, but don't care too much for marketing, and people who love marketing and don't care much for creating products. There are things that you do that other people either don't know how to or care to do on their own. This is where you step in and form a mutually beneficial relationship. An added benefit of making the right contacts is that even if you can't find someone to do what you need done for free, some of your contacts will know where to get quality work done through hidden channels at prices not revealed to just anyone. You have to be on the inside to get this kind of info. You've got to get it out of your head that everyone is your competitor, because competition is not really an issue once you understand that if you're willing to go above and beyond what everyone else is willing to do for their customers, competition is extremely light. Bottom line, once you have good contacts in place, you can easily get projects off the ground while those who are trying to do everything themselves struggle for months, if not years. It's the difference between having to spend $1,000 to get something done and having your contacts offer to do the exact same work for almost nothing. I guess it really comes down to one question. Do you want to put yourself ahead of the competition? Don't bury this report on your hard drive. I made that mistake for so many years. Accumulating things can get to be a habit that gets in the way of you learning from what you have and taking action on it. How much stuff do you already have buried on your hard drive collecting cyber dust, never again to see the light of day? You probably can't even begin to tell me, because collecting and forgetting is an easy and extremely unprofitable thing to do. I can promise you with 100% certainty that if you don't do anything with the information in this report, then it won't help you one little bit. However, if you're the kind of person I think you are, you realize what you now have in front of you. You have an opportunity to clear your head and regain your focus, but only if you're willing to put consistent effort towards the right things. What are the right things? Leverage, letting other people help you multiply your efforts on any project you create. Never create a project that other people can't help you promote. It just doesn't make sense to do everything on your own when hundreds of other people can pour thousands of combined hours into building your business for you. Have a clear picture in mind ahead of time and incorporate other people and what you need them to do into your overall strategy before you begin. Have a plan to reach your destination. Hitch a ride, look at what other people are doing and think of ways you can profit by helping them do more of it. Nobody cares about what you want unless it happens to coincide with what they want. Stop standing in people's way and instead push them towards the goals they're trying to reach. And stop falling at the feet of gurus waiting for them to throw out their leftover scraps. Pay more attention to what they do and a little less to what they say, because intentional or not, a lot of what they say has nothing to do with what they actually do. Sure, they may use the techniques and specific strategies they give you, but they're also operating with a bigger picture in mind that they either can't articulate because they don't fully realize what they're doing or simply won't tell the masses. You are your own leader. Look to others for guidance, but to yourself for the final word on what you should and shouldn't do. That's all for today. Reread this report to make sure the ideas start to sink in and figure out a way to adapt the hitch-a-ride concept to your marketing.
Introduction. You know, it's funny.
I took an entire year off from marketing online, and yet I can still come back and easily make money, even in a crowd niche like internet marketing.
Why? Am I any smarter than you?
I'd like to think so, but probably not. The only reason why I can take so much time off, miss so many new developments on how to market online, and still easily jump right back into business just like I never left is simple. I work from a different perspective than most people do. You'll get a clear sense of that as you read the rest of this report.
Making money does not have to be complicated. You just have to work from the right frame of mind. Really, all it takes is a little shift in the way you think, and you'll start to see opportunities where you never saw them before.
With this report, it is my intention to give you a new frame of mind to work from, and hopefully it will give you a renewed sense of purpose, because you'll know without a doubt that money is just a few hours worth of work/planning away.
Evergreen marketing secrets you can take to the bank.
Before I get into the heart of this manual, I want to make sure you completely understand the direction I'm taking. I have nothing against giving you specific techniques and strategies, because they are important, but they are never more important than the thought process that went into creating them. Evergreen marketing secrets refers to the fact that I'm giving you proven concepts that never stop working, based on the nature of the people you sell to.
People can change a lot of things about themselves, but their nature isn't usually one of them.
People can go against their nature for short periods of time, but rarely can they change it. In the future, you should make a conscious effort to try and understand why something is done instead of just copying what you see someone else successfully doing. There's always something more beneath the surface that you can study and learn from.
The concepts I'm going to reveal help you to tap into the minds of the people you want money from. People will almost never give you their money for your reasons.
What you have to do is show people that you want their money for the exact same reasons they want to give their money to somebody/anybody, and believe it or not, that's a lot easier to do than it sounds. Once you understand how to see what motivates another person, you can put yourself in position to show them how what you have to offer will help them do whatever it is they're trying to do.
That's really the only way to get someone's attention. Don't try to convince people they need what you're selling.
Show them how what you're selling will help them do something they're already trying to do.
That makes your product a natural fit for what they care about.
People care about themselves first, what they're trying to do, anyone else who seems to care about them, and anything that appears to be able to help them do more of what they already want to do. What I just said will become much clearer as you read the rest of this manual.
You will completely understand exactly what to say to people and how to structure your product offers in a way that's most attractive to the people you want money from. The basic truth about success.
I'm about to address one of the biggest obstacles standing in the way of you making money right now.
Being successful at anything you choose to do requires hard work and consistency.
I know that in the internet marketing field, use of those words is a big no-no, but it's the undeniable truth.
Without an understanding that you may have to work for your success, you might think there's some secret formula out there that's going to magically put money in your pockets simply because you know it.
Knowing this, I titled this report "Making Money Online for Newbies," because it implies that everything else is you've been doing is hard, and that I've found some simple secret you aren't aware of. It was the most direct way to get your attention, and I'm not the only marketer who understands that. All you have to do is look at how many products you've bought with the expectation that if you bought it, you would be able to turn your business around with the new secrets you thought you were going to learn to see I'm telling the truth. I know you've seen some people who have hit the net full speed with their first product and had all kinds of crazy success. Many times it's a fluke and it's not something that person can ever reproduce because since their first product launch did so well, they get trapped into thinking that what they did was easy, forgetting all the time and effort they put into everything that got them there. It's easy to get trapped into thinking that success is easy if you just have the right knowledge on your side. That's the big myth pushed on you by slick marketers who only want to sell you stuff. But the truth of the matter is success doesn't always come easy even if you know the best secrets out there. Anytime I need money, there are always a few basic concepts I can rely on that will always produce profits in a short amount of time without me having to spend any money on advertising. The only reason I know about these concepts is because I read pretty much everything I could get my hands on until one day things just started to make sense, but it wasn't easy to get to this point. When I started out, I had no money, no business or marketing background, no support from my family or friends, no computer knowledge and well, no computer. That's not the easiest way to start, but I didn't care. I wanted to be my own boss and be in control of my own life as much as possible. Period. Now, making money online isn't a dream for me anymore simply because I refused to let anything stand in the way of what I wanted. It did take me 2 solid years to start making money, however. The most important thing I've learned about what it takes to be successful is that you can't give up. Ever. Success has a way of waiting until 99.9% of the people who are looking for it give up in frustration before it decides to show up at your feet. It's a test designed to see who's worthy. Perseverance is a great element of success. If you knock long enough and loud enough at the gate, you are sure to wake up somebody. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. If you want to have a better business, or you want to make more money, or you want better things for yourself and for your family, what are you doing about it? Sitting back and wishing is easy. Criticizing other people for having the kind of success you want for yourself is dangerous and so easy to do it's scary. Sitting back and complaining that no one is around to help you is even easier. It's always easy to give yourself an excuse for not doing what you know needs to be done. Doing everything you can to make your dreams a reality and humbling yourself to ask for help when it's needed are where most people fall flat. Everything you need to get your business to where you want it to be can be found if you're willing to look hard enough. When I couldn't get support and understanding from my family, instead of getting discouraged and giving up, I turned to marketers who understood this crazy need I have to work for myself and were willing to help. When I didn't have a computer, I found someone who would let me use theirs whenever possible. When I didn't have a clue how to write HTML, I took every tutorial that popped up in the search engines. When I didn't even have $10 to spare for advertising, I learned, out of necessity, how to get thousands of targeted visitors a month to my sites for free. You have obstacles in your way, which may seem insurmountable at times, but they aren't. You may have family or friends who give you a hard time because they don't understand why you would want to put yourself through all frustration of trying to be your own boss. But in the end, most of them admire you for trying to do something they're afraid to do, which is to potentially risk your financial security in the pursuit of it. The myth of effortless success. How many money-making, supposedly life-altering packages have you bought in the last few months or years? Do you now have the success you bought those packages to achieve? Maybe you do, or maybe you don't. I'll let you in on a little secret. Almost anyone can make money using any of the money-making packages you'll find on the net. People do it every single day. The reason is because they understand that nothing magical will happen just because they bought the latest and greatest do-all/be-all, either get it or your life will be ruined product of the century. These people understand that consistent effort is what will set them apart from the thousands who get nothing from the very same products they used to make more in a month than most people make in a year. You would be surprised to know the kind of money some people are making with simple products that others say are worthless. It's your mentality that counts. How you think about the world around you determines your reality in it. Not everyone walking around on this planet operates from the same reality you do. People with failing businesses know it's hard to get to the top, and people at the top know it's easy for anyone to get to the top if they're willing to work hard on the right things to get there. Many of the obstacles holding you back were placed there by you and what you believe to be true. A lot of times, you may be the one who is creating the very rut you complain about being in.
Now right about now you're probably saying, where does you get off telling me I'm standing in my own way of success, but really I'm saying a lot more than that. It's not really your fault, because you're probably blind to the truth. Working hard is only part of the equation. You can try twisting a screw into a board with your fingers as hard as you can all day long, but I think you'd probably be better off using a screwdriver. In other words, working hard in the wrong way won't get anything done even though there's the appearance of action. Time to take off the tunnel vision glasses. We internet marketers have a tendency to get tunnel vision and only see other internet marketers when we want to learn what to do. The problem is that the internet marketers you choose to learn from likely learn from other internet marketers who, you guessed it, learned from other internet marketers. Dan Kennedy calls this marketing incest, and it could be the biggest reason why your success has been put on hold. What I mean by marketing incest here is doing what every other marketer is doing instead of thinking for yourself.
Is there anything you can do about it?
Of course.
There's always something you can do about everything in any situation. May not always be your first choice, but you can always do something.
One thing I do is spend time looking for products I'm interested in, anything not related to internet marketing, just to see how other businesses in markets not related to mine try and sell me their goods. That's how I came up with one of my main concepts.
Think about this.
Let's say you have a tractor and you use it to work your farm, which is what produces the income you live off of. When your tractor wears out a part, and it will, seeing as how it is the vehicle you consistently use to put food on the table, wouldn't you go out and look for a store that sells the parts you need?
Yeah, you would. Okay, now when you walk into the store, do the salespeople need to sell you on the benefits of getting your tractor fixed?
No.
You already knew the benefits before you walked through the door.
You already have money in your hands and are looking to give it to the first salesperson who finds the part you need to help you get back to doing what you already want to do.
Makes sense?
If not, everything will get a lot clearer in a minute.
The easy way to find money.
I'm not much of a fan of working hard. I'll do it, but only if I don't have a choice. That being said, I find myself working surprisingly hard trying to find the easiest ways to do things, and that's the reason I put this report together. To save you some of the time and effort I've put into working hard to be lazy and still make money online. What I've found is that even though you may know at least as much as some of your biggest competitors about making money, the reason you may not bank the kind of sales figures they do has a lot to do with a massive amount of leverage. Leverage is when you can put the efforts of 100s or even 1000s of other people behind you so they can help push you forward to do things you couldn't do on your own.
Think about it.
When was the last time you got an email from a guru about his latest product and didn't get at least 10 other messages from that guru's affiliates telling you about the exact same product?
Am I telling you to create your own product and start an affiliate program?
No. That's too much work. What I want you to understand is that many of your more successful competitors understand something that guides most of the actions they take in business.
What's that?
Why work hard by yourself when you can get other people to work hard for you as well?
How does that mindset apply to you?
Simple. You should never do anything online that doesn't multiply your efforts on a project even after you stop putting any of your time and energy into it. Your time is limited to 24 hours in a day, but 100s of people can put thousands of combined hours into promoting you.
The basic idea. If someone is running full speed at you, is it easier to stand your ground and try to stop them when they run into you or get behind them and push them forward?
Since they're already moving forward, it only makes sense that you'd have an easier and less painful time pushing them in the direction they're already headed in.
Right? I'll give you an example.
Let's say you start getting a lot of emails promoting one new product in particular, and this product seems to have a lot of buzz, negative or positive, it doesn't matter, and affiliates behind it. Many of the people I speak to tell me they simply delete emails like that, because they see those emails as being annoying, and all I can do is smile to myself, because I know what emails like that really are.
Easy money. Remember what I said about how easy it is to help people move in the direction they're already headed in? Well, if people have their minds completely made up to promote a particular product, then why not help them find more ways to do it?
You could, for example, create, or hire someone to create, a simple series of 5 to 7 articles promoting that product and then sell the reprint rights to your email series at $10 to $20 a pop.
Sell just 50 copies of your e-course and you've made $500 to $1,000 for something that should only take you a day or two in setup time. You don't have to worry about researching a niche, creating a huge product, managing affiliates, setting up joint ventures, or any of that. And you can set it all up so that PayPal.com pays you immediately whenever you make a sale, because instant cash is always great. The best part is that you don't have to find out if there's a demand for your information, because you can clearly see that there is, just from the sheer number of places you see promoting the product you're going to create an email series to endorse. All people really want is an easy way to do more of what they've already set their mind on doing. Sign up for as many newsletters as you want, and whenever you get a flood of emails promoting a particular product, instead of getting mad and rushing to the delete button, just smile and remember what I said. Help people go where they're already trying to go. Pretty much anyone interested in promoting the product you're getting all the emails on will snatch up the reprint rights to your email series without a long sales letter or any heavy convincing. They're already headed in a particular direction and will see your product offering as a vehicle to help them get there faster. Two easy ways to get traffic to your offer. Send out an email to your list announcing that you have a new email series for sale promoting a new product they're probably already interested in. Contact publishers and offer them reprint rights to your email course for free. The reason this is a good idea is because you'll be building a list you can send out your next offer to, so it's worth giving your email course away to people who can reach thousands of other people who will be interested in your future offers. Just make sure your emails link back to your site through your copyright notice at the bottom. The beauty of this idea is that you can do it several times a month, and every time you do, you build a list of people who will look forward to the next email series you create. You would be able to make money whenever you wanted with a few simple emails to your list. If you're interested in putting a little more effort into this, you could create a monthly membership site where you offer promotional tools for the latest products to hit the market. It's up to you. You can put as little or as much effort into this strategy as you want and still make it work for you. Opportunities for profit are literally everywhere you look if you consistently keep an open mind. Just remember to keep your mind open to ways you can use the concept of helping push people in the direction they are already headed in, so you can make more money. That's my hitch a ride concept. It's much easier to hitch a ride with someone to somewhere they're already going instead of trying to get them to take you where you want to go, which may be in the opposite direction. You'll encounter a lot of resistance that way. A lot of times, that's what we, as marketers, do. We try to convince people to do things we want them to do, like buy from us, instead of showing them how our products can help them get to the destination they've already picked out in their heads. Hitching a ride to success is nothing new. Back in 1848, the California Gold Rush began. People came from all over the world to claim their share of the wealth. Now you would think that the people who found the most gold were the wealthiest of the time, but that isn't exactly true. The actual fact of the matter is that the people who consistently became rich were the ones who sold tools to those who were mining for gold. People who never found 1 ounce of gold bought shovels, rugged jeans, and other supplies. Merchants who sold those tools consistently made money no matter how much gold was found. Selling the tools people need to do something they want to do will always fill your pockets with cash. This concept always works, and it never gets stale like specific marketing strategies. Try and wrap your mind around the concept, and you'll be able to come up with your own techniques to use it with. Make people have to go through you to get where they want to go. When you control the tools people need to do whatever it is they want to do, you control the actions they take, and that includes how they spend their money. If someone has to go through you to get to their destination faster, you can't help but make money. You see examples of people selling tools all the time. You just have to pay attention. Notice how many things you can't do unless you pay someone for his or her tool to help you do it. I haven't even scratched the surface. There are so many ways to use the concepts I teach that it literally boggles the mind. Spend some time thinking about how you can hitch a ride with people who are looking to spend money to get to their destination, and I'm sure you can come up with more than a few ideas. When you see people doing something they want to do, think about ways to get them to pay you to help them do more of it. By doing that, you won't need tons of specific ideas from me, because you will be able to come up with your own. I just wanted you to understand the basic idea of how this works.
Once you understand the basic idea, you'll never be at the mercy of gurus constantly trying to peddle specific ideas and strategies on you, because you'll understand the big idea behind how and why they work. If you look at it, all the gurus do is hitch a ride on your desire for a better life by giving you what you think you need, the latest secret marketing ideas, tips and strategies to give you an edge over the competition. If you think you need something else, they'll sell you whatever it is that you've shown an interest in. In other words, your major competitors, the people you learn from, are constantly trying to figure out what you want to do so they can sell you ideas, techniques, and tools to help you do more of it, knowing you will always pay for anything you think will get you closer to achieving whatever goals you've set for yourself. When you buy from one person over another, the only reason you do is because that person has done a better job, presentation-wise, of showing you that what they have to offer will help get you to your goals faster than the other guy. This idea works when selling any type of product or service. Find out what people want to do. Many times this is as easy as asking them, then show them how your product helps them do that. Always remember that the basis for creating products is to help people do more of something they already want to do. For example, if people want to make more money, instead of simply showing them how, give them an easy way to do it with a minimum amount of effort. Set everything up for them and allow them to plug into your system and get paid for sending buyers your way. Or you could create simple products based on hot trends you see and sell the reprint rights to that information, allowing people to profit from a trend they're already interested in. You should never run out of ideas for products, so you should never feel bad for selling the rights to something you've created, thinking that you just gave away a money-making product. Create something else and keep moving forward. The biggest thing to remember when you create products that you sell reprint rights to is make sure that those products lead back to your site in some fashion, so you can capture the names and email addresses of the people who visit. The simple truth that will always make you money whenever you want or need it. Every person who runs across your site has a secret desire. They want the benefits of what you're offering, but, here's a shocker, they really don't want to do much to get those benefits. The most persuasive and profitable product offers are the ones that make people feel as though they don't have to do much work to get all the benefits your letter promises. In other words, if you make your product offers sound too complicated, you'll lose most of the orders you could have had. I'm saying that you should explain your offer in rather simplistic terms that don't scare away potential buyers. You should always look to make your products and services as push-button as you possibly can. That's especially important with software programs. No one really cares how your product works. They just want to know that it does work and how they don't have to do much to get the benefits your product was promised to deliver. For the most part, people are very insecure about their abilities. Even when you show them proof that other people have done exactly what you're showing them how to do, most people still hesitate, because they don't believe they can do it. In other words, you need to put together systems people can just plug into and get results from. Most people don't want to know how to do something. They want someone who does know how to do something to do it for them, so they can either promote your something as an affiliate or buy the rights to your something and sell it without having to put in any real work. Understand this. If you have the time and you're willing to do something constructive, you will always be in a position to make money from people who want the benefits of doing something without actually having to put in any real work. That will always be true. What does that all mean as far as making money? To continue with my earlier train of thought, I created a special report that shows you how to take autoresponder courses you create and get other people to flood those courses with subscribers, but as I've said, people don't want to know how to do that. What they actually want is for me or you to create a system where they can buy the rights to an autoresponder course that is already set up, so they can use the technique I outlined to get other people to flood that course with subscribers for them, so they don't really have to do much. They want the benefits of using the technique without taking any of the time and effort to learn it and set it up for themselves. Think about that. For the most part, people complain about free detailed instructions on something that actually produces results with a little effort, but they would gladly pay $100 to $200 or more for a system that uses the very same technique they could have created themselves for free. Some of that is laziness, but mostly it's due to the fact that many people work hard at 9-to-5 jobs, have a family and other obligations that take up most of the time they would need to put various techniques and strategies they learn into action for themselves.
Both types of people will gladly pay for something that's already done for them, so if you're willing to put in a little work for those people, you can make as much money as you want. Some people make obscene amounts of money by doing what I just talked about. They trade a few weeks' worth of work for $40,000 to $50,000 plus in bankable profits. Alan says of the internet marketing warriors, wrote something about it in one of his reports along the lines of, "Any solution you come up with that makes it easy on people has a 100% better chance of selling than anything that requires them to work. The majority of people want things already done, and they will pay top dollar to have it done for them. Always keep your brain asking questions. Whenever you learn how to do something, ask yourself and find out if there's a market of people who would pay to have that done for them. You might not always be able to come up with something good, but sometimes you will.